liver. Our subject today is about liver. The liver is the largest organ in the body. It's found in the right upper quadrant of the abdomen. It's relatively much larger in the fetus and child. Here, first we must know about the ligament of the liver. We will talk about it briefly. The liver consists of many ligaments. First of all is the falciform ligament, which anchor the liver to the anterior abdominal wall. And right and left triangular ligament, which secure the two sides of the liver to the diaphragm. And the right coronary ligament, which are extension of the triangular ligament anterior to the liver. And here's the ligament teres, which is a remnant of the obliterated umbilical vein. This is the ligamentum teres. This is the ligamentum venosum, which is a remnant of the ductus venosum. At this base, the ductus venosum shunt the blood away from the umbilical vein to the IVC, which is bypassing the liver. This diagram showing fetal circulation, here the ductus venosum shunt the blood from the umbilical vein to the IVC, in which bypassing the liver. Surfaces of the liver. The liver is contained of two surfaces, diaphragmatic and visceral surface. Here is the diaphragmatic surface is smooth and flat posteriorly and has a smooth rounded upper surface with a large dome for the right hemidiaphragm and a smaller dome for the left hemidiaphragm. The inferior border of the diaphragmatic surface is made by a notch for the gallbladder and a notch for the ligamentum teres. The posterior inferior surface, in which also called the visceral surface, is a contain H-shape arrangement of structure. This H-shape arrangement is the crossbar of this H-shape is made by the horizontal hilum of the liver, which called the porta hepatis. This is the right loop, this is the left loop. The gallbladder lies in the bed inferior part and the IVC in the superior part, in which they are forming the right vertical part of the H shape. The left vertical part of the H shape is formed by the ligamentum teres inferiorly and the ligamentum venosum superiorly. This is also a photo of a visceral surface of the liver showing H shape. The visceral, first of all, this is the right loop, this is the left loop. This is the visceral surface of the liver is lies on contact and slightly molded by the esophagus and stomach on the left side, pancreas on the midline, and the right kidney and adrenal, and the left hepatic flexure of the colon on the right side. Old lobar anatomy. The old anatomical description of the liver as having a large right loop and a small left loop separated by the falciform ligament. Define the anatomical left loop as consisting only of segment 2 and 3. Two further loops are described, the caudate loop posteriorly between the IVC and fissure for ligamentum venosum, and the quadrate loop anterior inferiorly between the gallbladder bed and the fissure for ligamentum teres. Is as a old lobar anatomy, which describes the liver into smaller left loop and a larger right loop separated by the falciform ligament. It shows that consists, the left lobe was consist only of segment two and segment three, also contain the caudate loop posteriorly and the quadrate with quadrate loop. This is the old classification. And now we will describe the new segmental liver anatomy, about, which is called Conant classification. The Conant classification divides the liver into eight functionally independent segments. Each segment has its own vascular inflow, outflow, and biliary drainage. In the center of each segment, there is a triad of portal vein, hepatic artery, and bile duct. At the periphery of each segment, there is a venous drainage through the hepatic veins. The hepatic veins are intersegmental, draining the blood from adjacent segments. This is a new classification according to Conant classification, which is divide the liver by the plane of the middle hepatic vein, which is also called a principal plane. This principal plane divided the liver into right part and left part. This principal plane, which as I said, it is called the Cantley's line. It is run from the inferior vena cava to the gallbladder. The right hepatic vein divided the right lobe into anterior and posterior segments. The left hepatic vein divided the left lobe into medial and lateral part. The portal veins divided the liver into superior and inferior compartment. The right and left portal veins branch superiorly and inferiorly to run in the center of each segment. Segments are numbered in the Conant system in a clockwise direction, starting from segment one, which I mean caudate loop here, from number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The left portal segment two and three are the farthest left, divided by left hepatic vein from segment four. The left portal vein separates segment two above from segment three below. Segment four, which lies between the middle hepatic vein and the left hepatic vein, is also divided by the left portal vein into segment 4A and segment 4B. The right lobe has four segments, which is divided by the right hepatic vein into anteromedial and posterolateral divisions, and by the plane of the right portal vein into superior and inferior sections. These four segments is called 5, 6, 7, and 8 in a clockwise direction. This is also a photo showing the right physiological lobe and the left physiological lobe according to the Conant classification. The left lobe is contains segment 2, 3, 4, not the segment one. Segment one is not in the left lobe. Here is wrong. And the right physiological lobe. Right physiological lobe contains segment 5, 6, 7, 8. And there, here is a caudate loop. In the according to Conant classification, segment one has a different entity and not lies neither in the right or left loop. This is a photo showing an imaginary segmentation of the liver. This is a right lung, and how to remember the segmentation. This is the right thumb represent the caudate loop. This plane represent the left hepatic vein, and this is plane represent the principal plane of middle hepatic vein, and this is the right hepatic vein. This plane represents the portal veins plane. And we must remember that inferior compartment is 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 is always up, like in 7 up, 7, 8, 4A and 2. This is also another classification and according to the surgical and traditional anatomy terminology. The right part of the liver is divided into right lateral and right medial division by the right hepatic vein, and also divided into superior and inferior by right portal vein. The left part of the liver is divided into left medial and left lateral by left hepatic vein, and also into superior and inferior by left portal vein. This is another photo showing Conant classification. This is the right part of the liver. This is the left part of the liver. As we see here, the segment 6 and segment 7 lies posteriorly. So it is called right posterior section, while segment 5 and segment 8 lie anteriorly, so it is called right anterior section. Segment 4 is called left medial section, and segments 2 and 3 is called left lateral sections. This is another photo showing division of the liver into right and the left part by Cantley's line. This is the right anterior sections, and this is the right posterior section. This is medial, and this is lateral. This is left medial section and left lateral sections. Blood supply of the liver. The liver receives a dual blood supply from portal vein in 75% to 85%, and hepatic artery in 15% to 25%. Arterial supply of the liver. The common hepatic artery arises from the celiac trunk. This is the common hepatic artery arises from the celiac trunk, supplies the right gastric and the gastroduodenal arteries before approaching the liver in the free edge of the lesser omentum, anterior to the portal vein, and lies also medial to the common hepatic duct. It's divided in approximately equal size right and left hepatic arteries before entering the liver at porta hepatis. This photo showing a celiac trunk, which there's the left gastric artery, common hepatic artery, and splenic artery. The common hepatic artery give rise to right gastric artery and the gastroduodenal artery. This is the proper hepatic artery, which is divided into equal into right and left hepatic arteries. Variation in the blood supply of the arterial supply of the liver. The entire liver is supplied by a replaced common hepatic artery in 2.5%. The entire right lobe is supplied by a replaced right hepatic artery in 10%. Part of the right lobe is supplied by an accessory right hepatic artery in 6%. The left hepatic artery is replaced by left gastric artery in 12%. Accessory left hepatic arteries arise from left gastric in 13%. The common hepatic artery may divide early or trifurcate with the gastroduodenal artery. The hepatic artery may arise separately from the aorta rather than celiac trunk. This is a photo showing some anatomical variation in the blood supply to the liver. This is an accessory left hepatic artery, and this is an accessory right hepatic artery. Portal vein. The portal system is much less prone to anatomical variation than hepatic artery. It normally forms posterior to the neck of the pancreas by the union of the supreme mesenteric vein and the splenic vein at the level of the L1 to L2 disc space. It ascends anterior to the IVC and passes to the right in the posterior aspect of the free edge of the lesser omentum. It runs posterior to the bile duct and the hepatic artery to the portal hepatis. This photo showing that the portal vein is formed by the union of the of superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein behind the neck of the pancreas. Then it enters to the porta hepatis. At the porta hepatis, the portal vein branch into right and left portal veins. And the right portal vein is further divided into anterior portal branches, which supplies the segment 5 and segment 8, and posterior and right posterior portal vein, which supplying segment 4 and segment 7. This is the usual configuration. And also the system divide into left portal vein, which is give a branches to segment 2, 3, and 4. Venous drainage to the liver. The liver is drained by hepatic veins, which drain upward and backward to the IVC without an extra hepatic course. The right, middle, and left hepatic veins drain corresponding third of the livers. The middle hepatic vein lies in the principal plane and may unit with the left hepatic vein and have a common final course to the IVC. Hepatic veins have no valve. This is a photo showing venous drainage of the liver. This is the right hepatic vein, middle hepatic vein, and left hepatic veins, which they are drains to the IVC. Caudate loop. Caudate loop drives its arterial supply from both right and left hepatic arteries, and both the portal veins and its venous drainage, the drains directly into IVC. Plain abdominal X-ray. The margins are outlined by fat. Thus, the lateral border can be seen, which is flanked by pre-peritoneal fat. Intraperitoneal and omental fat lies near the inferior border. This border is best seen in obese patients, whose visceral surface tend to be less steep and more tangential to the beam on anteroposterior view. Air in the lung outline the pleura and diaphragm over the upper limits of the liver, but gas in the stomach may give a misleading impression of the position of the inferior border of the liver, as the stomach may pass posterior to this border. Ultrasound. Vessels on the bile duct of the liver are particularly well seen on the ultrasound studies. The liver is used as an acoustic window for visualization of other structures, including the right kidney, adrenal glands, gallbladder, and pancreas. The blood flow can be studied using color flow Doppler, and the direction and velocity of flow in the portal vein can be evaluated with a pulse wave Doppler. This is an image showing portal hepatitis. This is portal vein, hepatic artery, and the common bile duct. And this is IVC. It is also showing venous drainage. It's called bunny signs. Right hepatic vein, middle hepatic vein, and left hepatic vein, they are drainage to the IVC. It's also showing different photos with the segmentation of the liver. This is a superior segment of the liver, which is divided by the right, middle, left hepatic vein. This is segment 7, 8, 4A, and 2. This is left loop of the liver, which showing segment 2, segment 3, segment 4, and caudate loop. This is also left loop of the liver, showing caudate loop, segment 2, segment 3. And this is another photo showing the right and the middle hepatic vein, showing segment 7, 8, and 4A. And this is the right portal vein, which separate the segment 8 superiority from segment 5 inferiority. And this is the right loop of the liver, showing segment 6 and segment 7. This is a different photo ultrasound showing a different eco texture of the liver. This is a normal liver ultrasound. This is a fatty liver with increased echogenicity. And this is cirrhotic liver, which show ascites and the coarse and nodular texture. Riddle loop is a tongue-like inferior projection of the right hepatic loop. It is not considered as a true accessory loop of the liver, but an anatomical variant of the right loop of the liver. Male to female ratio of approximately 1:3. So it is more common in female. Riddle loop is an important variant to be aware of because it can be simulated as a mass. We must mention that riddle loop is considered as part of segment 6 if it is shown. Computed tomography. The relationship of the liver of the diaphragm to the diaphragm, pleura, and the lungs can be seen on CT. The relations of the visceral surface can be seen on lower cuts. That is the laser curve and stomach on the left, and the pancreas and duodenum posteriorly in the midline, and the right kidney and adrenal on the right. This is a CT showing a liver with some relations. This is IVC, this is aorta, stomach, spleen, right crust of the diaphragm, left crust, right lung base, left lung base. This is a cross section through the liver. This is through superior part of the liver, showing superior segments, which are segment 2, 4A, 8C, and 6. And the cross section through inferior part of the liver, showing inferior segments, which are segment 3, 4B, 5, and 6. MRI. On MRI, the liver is of equal signal intensity to the pancreas and higher on T1 and lower on T2 weighted image than spleen. Normal hepatic are seen as area of signal void on standard imaging. the major hepatic veins and the secondary branches of the portal veins are visible. Hepatic arteries less well seen and less intravenous contrast is given. This is MRI showing liver with some relations. This is liver, hepatic veins, inferior vena cava, stomach, spleen, and esophagus. This is also aorta. Hepatic arteriography. This is achieved via aorta and the celiac trunk with greater selectivity if the contrast agent is injected distal to the origin of the gastroduodenal artery. This is showing angiography. This is common hepatic artery, which give rise to gastroduodenal artery and proper hepatic artery. Proper hepatic artery give which is divided into right and left hepatic arteries. Gastroduodenal artery give to superior pancreaticoduodenal artery, and also give right gastroepiploic artery. This is the end. Any question?
In progress.
نختار نور محمد جواد.
نعم استاذ. هذا ميدل هيباتيك بين.
ميدل هيباتيك بين. اوكي. انسى عبد. تتشر لي.
نعم هذا رايت رايت بورتال بين.
اللي هو يفوت بين الميدل والرايت.
نعم
والشخص من هذا
يقسم لنا الابر ولور سيجمنت 8 تو 7 و 6 و
5. اوكي ليندا.
نعم استاذ هذا الرايت هيباتيك فين.
رايت هيباتيك. نور محمد الجواد. نور محمد.
نعم استاذ. ليفت هيباتيك فين.
ليفت هيباتيك فين. شنو الفحص هذا؟
التراساوند.
التراساوند. رقية.
inferior vena cava.
الكونفلونس اوف
inferior vena cava.
الهيباتيك فينز اللي تروح لل intrahepatic part of the IVC. اوكي. خلصت دكتورة دعاء. استاذ محمد.
اي استاذ رعد وياك. لارا.
نعم استاذ. اي ليفت هيباتيك ارتري.
ليفت هيباتيك ارتري. زين. رشا بي.
نعم استاذ. بي كمان هيباتيك ارتري.
كمان هيباتيك ارتري. زيد سي.
نعم استاذ. جاستروبلوك ارتري. رايت جاستروبلوك ارتري.
زهراء صباح.
نعم استاذ. الدي هو gastroduodenal artery.
gastroduodenal artery. والاي كزان.
نعم استاذ. right hepatic artery.
right hepatic artery. اوكي.
عائشة تيجي تشيل دكتورة دعاء.